We're going to do a few segments now on the part-time legislature, which is an initiative, I understand, to make the legislature in California part-time. Let me introduce my guests. They can explain it better than I can. Donna Lowe is joining us in the studio tonight. She's the co-director of the Citizen Legislator Now initiative campaign for Southern California. Donna's a 17-year resident of California, where she and her husband are raising their two children. In addition to her work on the initiative, Donna's also a candidate for the state assembly in a district she describes as from, what's that? Say it, Donna, for us.
All the Dinas. Pasadena South Pass and Altadena.
That's what that means. The Dinas. I'm thinking, what is a Dina? See, you're smart.
The local.
Got me to ask about your candidacy. That's very clever.
Excellent.
Mike Alexander, along with Donna, he's here in the studio. He's the Pasadena chair of the Citizen Legislature Now initiative. When not advocating for a part-time legislature, he is an investment advisor, and no wonder he was listening so closely, and proud, more important to me, Marine Corps veteran. Thanks for your service.
So that's, you're welcome.
Always humbles me. Hi. Some of you may know Mike as the president and founder of the largest Tea Party organization in L.A. County, the Pasadena Tea Party Patriots. Welcome, Mike. Now, you know I'm biased with Karen Kenney.
Right.
Yeah, she's just an unbelievable lady, and I'm sure you know her well, so I'm sure you're good, too. But
yes.
But we have to show deference to Karen.
Right.
And on the line on the phone is Assemblyman Martin Garrick, the 74th District. Where is that, Martin? Can I call you I should say Assemblyman.
No, Martin's fine, and it's North San Diego County from Del Mar up to Oceanside and out to Escondido. It contains 9 of the 18 cities of San Diego County.
You're the lucky guy. You're in San Diego, right?
Yes.
You don't have all the liberals here in Los Angeles County. We know about San Diego very well. Well, why don't I start by asking you guys, tell us about the initiative. Who wants to start with that?
I'll start. First of all, let me just point out that the website is citizenlegislaturenow.com. It's very important because there you'll find all the facts that we're going to go over tonight.
Now that's not on the June ballot, right?
Correct. It's not on the June ballot right now. We're trying to get it qualified, and it'll probably be on the November 2014 ballot. Mm-hmm. We're about halfway to our 800,000 signature goal, and so we're going to need a little bit more time.
But when do you need the signatures in by?
2 months from now, I believe it is.
Okay.
So, and the deadline and all that information is on the website citizenlegislaturenow.com.
Okay, great. And so I guess Mike can tell us about what it's about.
Yeah. There are two key features to this initiative. First, it deals with the timing of the legislature substantially reduces the number of days that the legislature is in session. And then limits the compensation of the legislators to about $1,500 a month. But the second and probably the more interesting and compelling aspect of this initiative is the establishment of a biennial or a two-year legislative cycle. And in the first year of the legislative cycle, they have to deal with the budget and virtually nothing else except emergency session. Then the second year, they can go back, and only if they've successfully dealt with the budget, then deal with other issues.
Assemblyman, do you want to add anything to that?
Well, yes. Thank you. First, I think we need to put into context that California operated just fine for 116 years, from 1850 till 1966, with a part-time legislature. Not until...
I didn't know that.
Yes.
That's interesting.
And not until 1967 did we have a full-time legislature with full-time benefits and full-time pay.
How did they get that past the voters? They must have said...
That was a gift from Governor Pat Brown and the legislature itself.
I see.
So there are only 4 states out of 50 that have full-time legislatures. That's California, Michigan, New York, and Pennsylvania. And just check out those economies.
Yeah, no, I this is very fascinating. I didn't know this. Only 4 left. Yeah, Michael.
That's great. No, the Assemblyman is quite correct on that. Most of the states in this union operate without a full-time legislature. Here in California, of course, when they have a full-time legislature, what that means is that they all stay up there in Sacramento and legislate. We had an onslaught of bills. I forget how many 100 bills were passed last year.
Over 700. Over 700 in here.
Actually reached over 800 bills.
Yeah.
And in my 6 years, and I'm term limited out and will be going out December 1, but in the 6 years I've been working up there, there's been 13,639 bills proposed,
on average
about 2,000 a year.
Chief Executive Magazine ranks California for the 8th year in a row 50th in business friendliness, and reasoning behind that is because businesses cannot possibly keep up with the regulation, the penalties, the new taxes, all of the things that come with us, with Sacramento sitting up there wondering, okay, what can we legislate today, what can we legislate?
Well, it makes sense to me. If you're going to go up there, you figure you got to pass laws. I wouldn't. You guys should be up there just saying no, no, no. In fact, that should be your campaign, right?
Right.
Get up there to say no.
Just say no.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
But one of the key things that we want to emphasize here is that the opportunity of the legislature to pass all these bills basically permits them to evade their principal responsibility of passing a budget, developing it early, seeing to it that it makes sense year over year, rather than concealing these problems. Now, if you hit the Drudge Report this afternoon, there's a big New York Times article proclaiming that California current budget is $16 billion behind.
Right.
Donna, what are the real numbers?
Yeah, it's far more than that because they don't take into account last year's carryover or the year before's carryover.
No, that's forgotten.
So this the budget that, and Martin can talk really to the specifics, but the budget that was passed last year was using imaginary numbers of what could be.
Yeah, well, the governor was way wrong.
Exactly.
He admitted that too.
And what's happening in California today, you've got welfare recipients, highest percentage in the nation. Our education is sitting at almost the dead last in national rankings. Our road and highways are crumbling. Like I said, we're ranked 50th in business friendliness, so we don't attract people to come here and start their dreams and create new ideas and be entrepreneurs here in the state anymore. And that's a big reason why I'm running for this seat as well.
Assemblyman, I ask everybody I meet, from Dan Walters to everybody else, where does this all end? Does California, just go bankrupt? I don't think they even legally can. Maybe they can. I don't know. Where does this all end?
None of us want that.
Yeah, so where does this all end?
Well, it can start, actually, with a part-time legislature, rolling back the bill factory up in Sacramento, reducing the amount of money that we spend in the legislature. There are 120 legislators, 40 senators, 80 state assembly members. Take a guess, Mark, what we spend annually on 120 legislators and their staff.
It's got to be millions of dollars, right?
$256 million a year. We could do it for less than 50 and save $200 million. There's a place to start right there. That's why I'm supporting the part-time legislature initiative, and have also introduced a bill as of Friday, ACA, that's Assembly Constitution.